Are we good? Are we here? So this is watching it work, as far as I know. I should have worn my gish medal. My bling, yo, I'll wear it next week. Oh, no, you know, my mom wanted to put it in a shadow box. So I let her take it home. I won't. I'll just wear the shadow box in the gish medal. This becomes ridiculous. This is watching it work. I'm Suzan-Lori Parks from the Lobby of Public Theater. And in case you guys don't know what we're doing, what we do is we meet here like every Monday, kind of sort of pretty much. And we have this is a free writing class. It's also a play. It's a meta-theatrical free writing class. For those of you who went to Harvard, I didn't. Anyway, so what we do is we write for 20 minutes and then we talk about your work and your creative process. For as long as the questions keep coming, you can ask them live if you're here, like some folks are here, or you can tweet them, and you're just going to tell us how to do that.
Yes, thank you.
So the way to tweet is that the handle is WatchMeWorkSLP, and if you send us a question, the hashtag is NewPlay. So that's WatchMeWorkSLP, hashtag NewPlay.
Thank you very much. And I think I have my timer with me, so we're going to set our timers for 20 minutes. Jeremy's gonna eat some chips. And hold on to my leg. No pun, mommy has to work.
You were just talking to me? Okay. Go ahead.
He's just hugging me. Excuse me. This isn't part of the show. Oh, here we go. Okay.
If he does that again, then I'll directly put you.
say thank you to Bonnie. Thank you.
Okay, that's time.
Good.
All right, that was
2 minutes. That was 20 minutes. So we're going to now we're going to talk about your work and your creative process. If anybody has any questions, now is the time.
Do you have any questions? I'm just keep eating your chips. Anybody?
Do you find yourself kind of writing multiple pieces and then jumping around?
Mm-hmm.
And is there ever a point where you're like, okay, I've got to put these, you know, I've got to make a choice?
Right.
And how do you, I mean, I think every artist probably, but how do you get to that place?
Right. That's blanking. I mean, that's Durham. That's blanking. What's your name?
Samantha.
Samantha, you know, behind you, June, right?
Yes, this is my
June.
Good friend.
Oh, June, huh? June was laughing behind you. She's laughing behind your back, literally. Because you guys are buds, so
yeah.
You know
yeah.
That she was laughing because she had a similar question, which is why I love this Watch Me Work, because it's basically just like the same five questions that we keep asking. And that doesn't mean that they're bad questions. It actually means that they're good questions. So it's always fun. So, do you have several projects? that you work on simultaneously?
Yes.
Okay, so then what do? You feel the, at some point you feel the need to, I gotta finish one of these, right?
What I'm finding is that one piece is getting very demanding.
Uh-huh.
So no matter what I do, I end up back there and I'm feeling distracted by it, if that makes sense.
So you have several pieces that you're working on simultaneously. More and more like dim sum.
Something like that, yeah.
Dim sum or the joke, the lazy Susan, we call it. This is a top ten typewriter, so we have to keep it nice. The lazy Susan, right? And so you kind of turn it around, and maybe this week you're working on this piece, or this hour you're working on this piece, and then tomorrow or whenever you turn it and you work on the next piece, right?
Yes.
And right, and then at one point, one of the pieces becomes demanding.
Yeah, I mean, for lack of a better.
Yeah, that's a great way to describe it. It's like going, hey, me. And then what do you do?
I mean, I think I'm kind of blocked and stuck. I mean, I hate saying that.
Yeah.
I'm kind of at a point where I've written to a point and now I'm not sure where to go next.
So it's kind of not that the piece becomes demanding, but is it demanding to be finished, or is it giving you, like, for lack of a better phrase, constipation issues?
A little bit of both. A little bit.
So you're doing this?
Yeah. A little bit.
Right, and you're going.
A little more histrionic.
Sure. Okay, I understand. So the question is then how do you choose between projects? Which often we have that question.
Yeah.
The question is how do I roll away this kidney stone?
Yeah.
Pass this stone. How do I pass this stone? How do I. Let the love flow.
Yeah.
So do you have a regular writing time?
Yeah.
Okay, and when is it?
It's around now and then early in the morning.
Okay, so great. Wow, look at you. You have two regular
writing
times.
I try.
Well, that's fantastic. Okay, and about how long do you spend?
In the morning it's easier, so like an hour or so.
Okay.
It's just walking around, speaking it.
Okay.
For dialogue, and
okay.
then at night I'm a little more distracted. That's when I notice the different pieces getting.
Okay. Is it possible to put more time in the other, the morning, and let the other time go, or?
That's what I'm trying to do. I think it's more like, no, I must do this now. And that's the time I have, and then I.
Okay.
Go
so how do you demarcate the time?
I time it.
Okay,
actually have it on my phone. It'll go off. Okay, stop.
Great. So what we talked to someone, I think it was a week before last, about, it was Brett. No, yes, it was Brett. And he was having a birthday, I know we have someone here who comes here named Brett, and he was having a birthday, but I'm not sure if he asked this question. We talked about maybe it was Andrew, how to redefine how he defines success, right? So while you're working on passing this, for example, I mean, the ultimate stone passer, right? Jesus.
Yes.
So he's just lying. Right?
That's true.
But it's true, if you think about it. He's just, he's been through a lot. I mean, let us believe that he's whatever, God or whatever, we can, put that to the side. The historical guy, he'd been through a lot, right? Many, you could say you've been through a lot. You've written maybe more than one draft, right? Okay, you've been through a lot. And now he's gone through all the thing and the cross and the thing and his mom cried. And he's lying there in the dark. Going, I'm blocked, man. I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing. Right, that's kind of you. There you are. You're trying to pass the stone, which is what, roll away the stone. It's kind of the same thing. Right. So we're gonna change how you call yourself successful, and we'll do what he did. You're just gonna put the time in. That only took him 3 days. Okay, cool. It might take you, a month. But what you're gonna do with consistency and faith is you're gonna show up at your writing time for the appointed time. You can get yourself invited.
buy yourself a present in anticipation of your success. And I don't get a kickback on these, I swear.
Yes.
A timer, which is not your phone.
Right.
So you buy yourself a gift in anticipation of your success. Buy one that's easy to program. You know, don't buy one of those confusing ones because you have to read the instructions. Okay, so you buy something in anticipation of your success. You show up at your writing time, your time's an hour. You might set the timer for 30 minutes, and then once you set it again for 30 minutes. So it's not your phone, meaning June isn't going to be calling you on your timer. It's not going to happen. So you're already ahead of the game. No one who loves you will be distracting you with love. You will put the time in, 5 days a week, you're right? Okay, well, I mean, let's just say, the weekends are kind of dicey, you know?
Yeah.
So if you can do 5 days a week, 5 days a week, 1 hour, 2 30-minute increments with faith, and you just show up, and you sit there with maybe your pages, or you stare at the screen, you don't get on Facebook or check out what Dash is doing, right? Let them go, right? You're going to show up with your pages, with your story, and just either write something, doesn't matter if it's good or not. You're going to spend an hour, 5 days a week just showing up. If it worked for him, it'll work. No, really, that's what I do. I just show up. Because what happens when we're blocked or whatever is we go, in the tomb. That is almost awesome. Not do G O. I spell doom. I spell tomb, something like that. Okay, so it's close. So you could confuse the two. You just where you are.
Yeah.
Right?
It's feeling a little there I am. And I'm like, did I take on too tough a topic? I mean,
that's what, you know, imagine the voices that Jesus heard, or Job, or whoever, or Susan Anthony, or Harriet Tubman, or whoever you want to put in the place of someone who, you know, went through something difficult. Harriet Tubman's in the woods, trying to get somebody to free him, and she's like, oh shit. You know what I'm saying? You continue. All those voices are voices that we all have heard, and everybody who's ever tried to do anything wonderful. They're in good company.
Okay, cool.
No, really. And just say two voices. You say, you know this gesture?
Yes.
Can you do it? Yeah. Right?
That's
enough. Thank you.
Yeah.
Right. Emphasis. Thank you. And, right? Okay?
Yes.
See, look at your spirit. You're all radiant and smiling.
Yeah, that was helpful.
Yeah, you should come more often.
She just heard
some French.
That's
how I like it.
Anybody else have a question? Crystal,
how
you doing?
I'm fine.
Oh.
So I'm working to. I'm trying to balance two things out.
Right.
So maybe I'll ask the next question after.
Okay.
But the play I'm currently working on. I'm almost halfway there.
Right.
And I'm having a lot of trouble with, I think, writing for the sake of, it's just very emotionally hard. So there's a lot of violence, there's a lot of hate, there's a lot of anger. Back and forth because it sits right here.
Right.
a stress or an anxiety.
Right.
That has to be written. But the reason why I said, okay, I will write this is because in the midst of all of it, there is this friendship, this hope that's supposed to bring light some way, somehow.
Right.
But it's just so, so grimy. Everything is so not light.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm just having trouble getting through it.
Wading through the valley of the shadow of death. Sorry, it's all the Bible.
It's all
the
Bible. You know what?
Yeah, I mean, really, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I do that because it's like a story we've all heard before. It can apply to what we're doing now. So that's why I'm doing
it. But that's precisely right. It's feeling like I'm in the valley of the shadow of death. And just like, wow, there's no light. I know I got to get light somewhere because then there's no point to the play. If it's just, I mean, I don't know. I feel like there's a calling. There's more to it than just darkness. But I understand that it's necessary for me to go as far as it takes me. I'm just having a hard time not separating myself.
Right.
I'm having a very hard time. Maybe I'm weird, crazy.
No. So what you can do when we're writing difficult, something Crystal's writing, something that's important, and it's also challenging, and it's dark. It feels like she's walking through the valley of the shadow of death. So to write it. So what you can do is, number one, coming here and talking to people about it is good, or just talking to people about it is good. We're going to...
He's probably
going to
cook
one. But what you can do is talk to people about it. Just let some air in and some light in, okay? And you don't have to be specific about your play. You can just say what you did right now. You can also... do things like, where do you write?
In my room.
In your room. What time of day?
Nighttime.
10, 11. The kids are asleep?
11, 12.
Okay, 11, 12. So what kind of lighting do you have?
Lighting?
I mean, you have fluorescent lighting, you have someone standing there with a torch. What do you do?
It depends who's in the room. If there are kids in there, and it's just a little lamp, or it's like highlight, the fan light.
Okay, so you get to get yourself a present too. I believe in giving yourself presents. So you get to get yourself a present too. So you could go to the CVS, I don't know where they sell these things, a little votive candle, a little yardside candle, a little small candle, okay? Votive candles, you know, the little round ones, the tea candles, they call them at CB2, the fancy stores. You sprinkle them, okay. He's having some artistic concerns also. But what you can do is buy yourself a little candle, small, modest. They come in either those clear jars, they sell them at like Duane Reade, probably in the candle section, right? And you buy yourself a little candle. A present, costs like $1. And then when you go to write, what will you write? You can light the candle. That's not going to distract the kids in the room or anything. Huh? I mean, I hope not. Okay, they're hardy. And you say, this is the light. I need to work this evening on this difficult play. This is it. This is the light. And you can wherever you think it's appropriate to say it came from, you know, where it came from. You know, the characters in the play are helping me light this light, and they want me to finish the play. You could say my grandmother is helping me light this light because I'm finishing the play. You know what I mean? Anybody who inspires you. You can light that thing about, or you can just light the candle and just say, this is the light that I need. You know, it's symbolic of the greater light that I'm looking for in the play. It's right here. You can do that. Okay, so you try to start a little present. And again, like you said, we're not going to do
Samantha.
same as you were saying to Samantha, keep steady with your writing time. That's the most important thing. When we're walking through the valley of shadow of death, it's easy to go, oh, I just want to go and get ice cream. And it's okay if sometimes that happens, but if it happens as a habit instead of your writing time happening as a habit, you're not going to get work done. All right?
Knees.
Should have a little mirror.
If you see him get on his feet, just tell him. Jason.
Anybody else have a question?
Also, you know, like that,
enlist the help of friends. See, this is, it's interesting. It was relatively easy to get a babysitter. I choose not to because I want to see what it's like. I want to up the difficulty. It got to the point where it was very easy for me to do this. Because we've been doing this for 6 years. How long have we been doing this? Carol's home, like 6 years or something. We started out downstairs. And anyway, so I got to the point where, oh, it's neat. I can work, I can do stuff, I can figure out stuff in front of people. Lunch box. self-conceptual tour. The ability to somehow stay the course regardless of the negative voices that are chattering at you. So, what I want you to do, how soon can you be done with this piece right here?
Well, I mean, it's like 15 pages right now. It should be 95. Well, it's because it's on the screen.
Okay.
So they say it should be 95.
Okay, so that's like what, 2 days?
Like, I mean, if I'm sitting alone, I'm like, it, like, this was done in a day or something.
Yeah, we got, like, can you do it in, like, a week? Great. I want you to do it in a week. Okay? Can you do it in a week? You can do it in a week. No, you can do it in a week. I mean, you're on page 15 now. Somebody good at math? Anybody? Here you go. Quality.
No. We're going to give you points for quantity. We just want you to say, yeah, I finished. That's how you're going to measure your success. See, we just changed the measurement of success. So all you have to do is say, I wrote it, and I wrote the end, and I'm done. And it's about however many pages, 95 pages. That's actually, in a week, that's, I could do that. I got little Mr. Sunshine over here. You know what I'm saying? You can totally do it. Because what I want you to do is just develop the habit of sticking to something and just going for it. You're going to hear negative voices in your head. Oh my God, what? I just dreamt this and got out of bed and started it out of the blue? What? I should start rewriting something that I thought about a little bit more. The negative voices, right? Okay? So thank you for admitting your crimes, your sins, and go forth and sin. No. Okay, can you do it in a week? Okay, great. Can you see? It's going to be great. It's going to be fantastic. Sometimes you just have to hypnotize yourself, right, into the right mindset. Yeah, you do. I do it all the time. I just hypnotize myself. Because either we're doing that or we're hypnotizing ourselves into the wrong mindset. I can't do this. What am I doing? What is my life amounting to? Right, so you gotta just hypnotize yourself.
She's stick to it, isn't it? Like,
well, okay, well then apple don't fall apart from the tree. Why? That bean is in the house. Taking a break from Hamilton, brother. God, no, okay, let me think. Look at him. Mr. Fabulous is over there. Thomas Jefferson. Anybody else? Yeah, Carol.
Sometimes when you get to that spot that seems so dark and that you're having trouble with, maybe that's just the feeling that you need to express and get it out and use it, and it's pointing to something to you that you want to use that energy in the work rather than against yourself. I don't know if that makes sense.
That's great. Well, you say that sometimes when you're in a dark place in your work, that's a place where you really want to focus and use the energy. So is there a way that you can use the dark energy for fuel? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
And not something to self-flagellate, like, or hit your head against the wall.
No, you know what's interesting about, like, as an actor, like, it's so different, because you have to use it. You have to go right into the belly of the beast. But I feel like with writing, you're doing similar things as preparing, but it's lingering because you've got to create this realm, this world, and it doesn't leave you. Until you can't sleep well, you're hardly eating, and you know what I mean? It's the pregnancy thing. Like, you know, I feel like when I'm acting, it's an exorcism almost. It comes out every time, but it's coming out where with this, it's I have to be patient because of the writer part. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
The gestation so period is different.
Yeah.
It's different. It's like having a baby elephant. You know what I mean? It's
a demonic baby elephant.
Yeah, well, yeah, but if you do not write it, you will not exercise it. No doubt.
And isn't writing is acting on paper to me?
Kind of. I mean, we could say we're reading it off the great wheel in the skies. We are. But, you know, you're just unrolling from the great school on good days. On bad days, you're hitting your head against the wall.
Yeah.
Anybody else have a question? No, Carol. Yes.
What's your name?
Hi, I'm Ashley.
Hi, Ashley.
This is my first time here.
Yeah.
So my question is, for people who are coming in and writing, and what's the purpose of the writing? Are people here just, are they making plays? Are we doing this to just get off our feelings? Like, what's the purpose of most people writing? Are we making a book? Are we making a film?
Good question. What are most of you guys, I mean, I won't answer for myself. What are you guys working on? Crystal, what are you working on?
A couple things. Myself.
I'll just say, Crystal's writing some plays, and June's writing a screenplay, a novel, excuse me, June's writing a novel. Samantha, what are you working on?
A book for a musical.
A book for a musical? This is just like, you know, just in their spare time. What are you guys doing? You're working on like 5 to 20 different plays over here. Alexis is, well, she's working on a lot of things, and she's cheating on, she's writing something new as of last night. She's going to finish this time next week. Derek is working on being 4. Big job. I'm working on a TV show.
Yeah.
You know, just to kind of, Derek's still working on being 4. What are you working on?
I came in, I didn't know this is what it was going to be.
Right.
I've actually been like trying to write a couple shows that me and my friends have been doing, but I haven't had much inspiration to finish it. So I actually just started writing about like just some new stuff I want to do, like some goals I have, some workshops that I want to do, and stuff like that. So that's kind of what I wrote today.
That's good. I mean, basically the most important thing is to sit down and put the time in. And you know, we're at this part of the year where we're thinking about like, what do I want to accomplish? What did I do this year? How do I manage distractions? And what do I want to do next year? How do I want to build on what I did this year and go forward to next year? So that's a cool thing to do. Whatever sort of gets you pointed in the direction of doing the thing that you want to do. And sometimes we take like a big, huge, ginormous step. Oh, look at me, I wrote 100 pages today, you know what I mean? And sometimes all you can do is point your feet in the direction, and that's all you can manage. But doing a little something every day, as best as you can, is very important. You know, so we're just here to sort of encourage that. And have fun. And three people and roll away the stone, and you know. Well, I'm gonna have a question. No, June, you was just waiting. Anybody else? Are you worried it's gonna fall? You know what? Yuvika says this is gonna fall on you and hit you in the head, and then we don't want that happening, so why don't you clear it? Thank you. Thank you, sweetie pie. Thank you. I appreciate that.
The other's part. So I have the play that we've been working on for the last couple of years, the Zeph and Violet play.
Yes.
Someone is interested in reading it.
Oh, that's exciting.
Yeah, it's very exciting. It's kind of a big door.
Someone like a
theater.
A theater. Oh,
yeah.
Exciting. Really nice.
Yeah.
That's good.
So it's still 3 parts, but it's still very long.
Right.
Like, I know it's too long, but I've heard it. I haven't heard the first part, just the last two. And I literally was able to cut down about, you know, maybe 10 pages. But we're still at like 147 pages.
Okay.
And so I still enjoy whatever.
Right.
But I don't know if it's too much. If it's too much.
For somebody to read?
Not for someone to, I mean, I guess I'm thinking production wise.
Oh, okay, don't think production wise.
Or
don't
just.
Okay, so.
I mean.
Oh,
okay.
All you're doing, somebody, here you have your play, somebody in the theater that you like, right, says they want to read it. It's so dating. I mean, you're not going to like marry them. You're going to just like go out for coffee and check out the situation. Right? You're not going to make them married and have their children. Maybe you will, but not like next week, right? You're concerned about, are you like cool enough to go out on a date? 140 pages, a lot of pages. Okay, so what you might do is just include with the play a little cover note saying, among other, you know, thank you for reading my play, blah, 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 blah. It's the story of this and that, whatever. I wrote it because whatever. And while it's a little, maybe it's a little on the long side right now, I look forward to, you know, doing a rewrite, writing trim if necessary. You just put that in. You know, say you're open to the possibility of cutting if that is what the plan needs.
Can I have to
take
that verbatim?
Say what?
Can I take that verbatim?
I forgot what I said already, but.
Open to the possibility if that is what the plan is.
Yes. Yes. If that is the plan. Because, you know, it's played on me, I don't do it. Because you're just dating. You're just going out for coffee.
I know. But, you know, you date, but you're also aware of the baggage. You're also aware of what's
everybody
the, what you're coming
that's
in
it.
With.
It's not the baggage, it's how you handle it that counts. Yeah, everybody's got baggage. You know, even Mr. Cordial has baggage. People have baggage. Got stuff that happened in the past. It's how you handle it. That's what counts. And you handle it in a cool way, like, hey, I'm open to the possibility of da 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 da, you know? Finish that.
Yeah, it's due in late January.
Okay, so you know them places like McDowell and Yaddo.
McDowell is a writer's colony. Yada is a writer's colony. And there are lots and lots and lots and lots, and lots of writer's colonies. So those are the two that came to mind. Those are two awesome programs that will let you come up with. They'll feed you and house you and give you space to write. They're amazing. Those three things right off the top. There's something called the War, right?
Yeah.
So you know more, you probably know more than I know about this fellowship. But you frame yourself as, this is who I am, this is what I'm doing. You know what I mean? And every, you know, success you have that you put on your resume, every production, every reading, every play you write is a success. Everything you write is a success. You can put on your resume. To show people that you're serious about what you're trying to do. We want to be available for that.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll see. So what should they do? Check the website? Okay, so check the website. We'll know in a couple of days. Okay. I love it that you all come. It's great. It's great. We have one more and then we're done for the year and then we're going to be back. And after, probably under the radar, probably, right?
Yeah.
Okay. After under the radar, too.